Welcome to this YouTube channel about cryptocurrency education. Today I'd like to talk about the upcoming Cardano Alonzo hard fork and talk a little bit about the programming language, because I believe the programming language that Cardano use for the smart contracts really provides a competitive edge for Cardano, and this will really be seen in the month coming forward and might also boost the price going forward, because it just will lead to more adoption of Cardano's blockchain, of Cardano smart contracts, because security in the end is something that is very important. And I believe security is really one of the things that Cardano smart contracts will provide. And I'll talk about a few examples. But let's start with just a short introduction of what's currently going on in the Cardano world. If you are familiar with Cardano, then you'll know that we are on the road to the Gogon era, which is really the next big phase in Cardano's overall blockchain development, which again will bring forth the smart contract functionality. And this is what everybody has been waiting for. And as you probably will know, this the latest development is currently being improved and implemented on top of the solid Cardano structure in the Alonzo testnet. Now, this upcoming Gogon era, yeah, which is basically the era in which smart contracts are live, this has actually been methodically formed to bring considerable modifications to Cardano that will then produce a scalable, lasting, and also interoperable blockchain network. Now, what I really like on Cardano is that each of the eras, there have been various different eras in the Cardano history, and some will also come in the near future. And the upcoming Gogon one, which then includes the smart contracts, is just one of them. But each of these eras has actually been designed from the beginning to be really according to the objective of the complete and finalized development of Cardano's blockchain network. So this is one of the strengths of Cardano, that it has been really methodically really been applied and carried out, this project, really in a methodical way. And I believe this is one of the big strengths of Cardano. But currently, the upcoming Alonzo hard fork will offer a platform that really can take advantage of the road outlined by all the previous developments with the introduction of these smart contracts in the Cardano ecosystem. And we are already in the Alonzo blue phase, which is the first test net that is rolled out on this roadmap that will eventually lead to the Alonzo hard fork, which will happen August, September, when the smart contracts will come live. Now, at the moment, this is just a closed testnet in which developers and pioneers can test the first contracts. And Cardano have confirmed that these first smart contracts have successfully been applied on the testnet already. So there's good news. And I believe the original plan was that the next phase of the testnet will go live still in June. I don't know if that will still happen, but I believe we're on a good way. Haven't heard anything else, anything different. Now, these pioneers that are actually participating, they are all the developers that have been recruited by Cardano a while ago, and they have all been trained in programming these smart contracts. So again, a really good way to push this forward. And they are all invited now to these Cardano blue and white phases. I believe in the blue phase, not everybody is invited, but in the white phase, this will be further rolled out. More developers will come in. And in this Cardano white phase, I believe also the plan is to integrate some of the, off-chain elements that need to be integrated as well. And then possibly around July, August, we will have a public testnet in which everybody can then test the smart contracts. This is also the time then when the exchanges will prepare for this hard fork, this upcoming hard fork. Now, as you might know, and this is really what this video is about, as you might know, these smart contracts are really based on the Haskell or Plutus programming language. I don't know if it's called Plutus or Plutus, probably Plutus. Tell me if I pronounce it in the wrong way. But again, this is based on the Haskell programming language. And first, I'd like to talk about why actually, where does this name Alonzo come from? And you might know it, you might not know it. I'll talk about it quickly, because that will lead me to actually what I want to talk about in this video. So this name Alonzo is not actually just a name they came up with. It is actually based on the US mathematician Alonzo Church, who lived between 1903 to 1995. And Church worked on a number of really foundational areas of computer technology today. And he's also credited with uncovering a programming language that is called Lambda Calculus, which is often called the smallest universal programming language in the world. And the thing is that any kind of computational function can be looked at really utilizing mathematics. And this smallest universal programming language eventually is based on mathematics. And this is where the choice of this name came from. Now, this is not just, still, it's not just unintentional, because the Plutus core language behind Cardano Smart Contracts, and again, the Haskell language, which is also, again, very much related to the Plutus language, they are based on the concepts of Lambda Calculus that basically Alonzo Church discovered or developed. And with this programming language, the Cardano blockchain will become programmable. And Cardano have developed these smart contracts in a completely new way. So they've built them up from scratch, basically. They're not based on anything that's already existed. So they've really built them up from scratch. And they are all based on the Haskell language. And exactly with this, as it's all based on mathematics, errors can be found much easier. And the big advantage is that these smart contracts, then they do what they are supposed to do because of mathematics. And because errors can be much easier found and prevented, these smart contracts should really be much more secure than other, you know, smart contracts on competing platforms. Because in the past few months, we've seen again and again, and there have been numerous examples, you just need to Google it, that money was stolen on DeFi applications due to weaknesses in the code, due to errors, due to security flaws. And I think this is really where, going forward, Cardano can really play its strength out, because this programming language they use and the smart contracts in a universal way, they have a massive advantage compared to many other competitor smart contracts or networks, because it's all based on this Haskell programming language, which it provides a much more secure way and a much better way to prevent errors in the code. Now, making the use of Plutus or Haskell when establishing these smart contracts will therefore certainly give the smart or the blockchain a greater degree of safety. And as I already said, these smart contracts on the Cardano network, they've been designed from the ground up to be very secure and mathematically verifiable. And that is really what it's about. They all can be verified using mathematics. And with this higher focus on security, hacks and attacks can hopefully be prevented much better. And therefore, because, you know, all the dApps on the blockchain will be based on this programming language, I believe this will be, you know, going forward, this will lead to much better adoption of the Cardano network. And I believe at the moment, people can't really, they don't really yet understand, a lot of people don't really yet understand the actual advantage of this. But when it comes to really maybe financial applications, what eventually Cardano is about as well, and maybe even, you know, social media, where, you know, data and everything, all the security of this will be so important. And I believe this is one main reason why Cardano could secure these contracts in Africa with Ethiopia as well and Tanzania. I think they're also talking to El Salvador at the moment, who, as you probably know, are integrating Bitcoin as legal tender. And just imagine Cardano as a decentralized financial application for El Salvador as well. That would certainly give Cardano a major boost. So this is really everything I wanted to talk about today. Really a major advantage, I believe, is this programming language in the Cardano network. Now, if you want to support spreading the word about Cardano, then please smash the like button and also subscribe to this channel. And if you want more content like this, please also hit the notification bell. All right, so hopefully you liked it. If you did, then hopefully I'll see you in the next video. Thanks a lot for watching, and bye.